In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today the Church celebrates the Feast of the Exaltation of the Holy Cross. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you come to gather the nation into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in glory and salvation for your people. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you. We glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who willed that your only begotten Son should undergo the cross to save the human race, grant, we pray, that we, who have known his mystery on earth, may merit the grace of his redemption in heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Numbers. With their patience worn out by the journey, the people complained against God and Moses. Why have you brought us up from Egypt to die in this desert, where there is no food or water? We are disgusted with this wretched food. In punishment, the Lord sent among the people Sarah serpents, which bit the people so that many of them died. Then the people came to Moses and said, "We have sinned in complaining against the Lord and you. Pray the Lord to take the serpents from us." So Moses prayed for the people, and the Lord said to Moses, "Make a seraph and mount it on a pole. And if any who have been bitten look at it, they will live." Moses accordingly made a bronze serpent and mounted it on a pole. And whenever anyone who had been bitten by a serpent looked at the bronze serpent, he lived. The word of the Lord. Do not forget the works of the Lord. Hearken, my people, to my teaching. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter mysteries from of old. While he slew them, they sought him and inquired after God again, remembering that God was their rock and the Most High God their Redeemer. But they flattered him with their mouths and lied to him with their tongues. Though their hearts were not steadfast toward him, nor were they faithful to his covenant. But he, being merciful, forgave their sin and destroyed them not. Often he turned back his anger, and let none of his wrath be roused. reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ Jesus, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on the earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to Nicodemus, "No one has gone up to heaven except the one who has come down from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning. Good morning to the students of the school. Today, the church celebrates this feast of the exaltation of the Holy Cross. The cross. The cross is the mystery of our salvation. We Christians venerate the cross. Jesus Christ died on a cross. But was raised from the dead. What is the cross? There is the cross of Christ, which is, you know, the place that God, in his plan of salvation, chose to save us. Jesus, the Son of God, had to die on the cross. The death on the cross at the time of Jesus was the worst death. He chose the worst death to save us. The cross shows what sin did to God. This cross is a beautiful cross, but there is not too much blood. There are very nice crosses full of blood. You see the movie Mel Gibson, The Passion of Christ. Everybody loves the movie, right? But he created a lot of problems because it was too much. It was not too much. It was even worse, the death of Jesus. I read my phone a picture of the cross. This is what sin does, because God loves the sinner always. An immense love for the sinner, but doesn't love sin. And the cross reminds us that sin is not a joke. But Christ destroyed sin in his body on the cross. So that's why there is the exaltation of the cross. We don't exalt people, we exalt the cross. But we Christians, each one of us, have a cross. The cross, which is the symbol of what destroys you. personality, a cross equal a fact in your life today. Look at your life today. What is making you suffer that makes you even doubt the love of God? What is somehow that thing that you will erase from your life? You say, this, I can't take this situation. Maybe it's a sickness. Yeah, COVID. Maybe it's a son, an economical situation. Whatever is making you feel limited, powerless, is the cross. But attention. The good news is that we Christians are enlightened by the cross. The cross, this very fact, this very situation that is threatening you, in the sense, not being what you would like to, or makes you suffer, is the very means by which Christ draws you to Him. If we don't have a cross, we cannot be Christian. Jesus says many times in the Gospel, "Do not follow me, take up your cross every day and follow me." The cross of every day, today's cross, not tomorrow's. What's today suffering you? Making you suffer? In that very situation, if you accept it, you need Jesus Christ there, because Jesus Christ wants to have a personal relationship with you. But if we love our ideas, our comfort, our world, our plan, we don't need Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is in the cross. But since He died on the cross and destroyed sin and death in the cross, now, the good news for us is that whenever there is an event of death, whenever there is a situation that somehow makes you suffer, Jesus Christ, if you believe and you accept it, and you stay there without, you know, rebel, He will carry the cross for you. He will carry the cross for you. Any suffering, imagine a person in the deathbed, a person with a disease. How can possibly, what is the meaning of life with suffering? Does suffering have meaning? Absolutely. For the world, no. For us, yes. Suffering has a redeeming value. But also for us, it's the opportunity that God has put in our lives to become humble, to become holy, which means to be with Christ. Everybody has a cross. It's not that we have a cross, the other one has. Everybody has a cross. The difference between us and someone who doesn't believe is that we are enlightened. We see the meaning of the cross. Yes, it's uncomfortable. Nobody wants to suffer, obviously, right? Then there are physical suffering, there are moral suffering, which are even worse. Moral suffering. You feel betrayed, or, precarious situation, that also the situation with the church, whatever it is, a moral suffering. But remember always, you are not alone in the suffering. Jesus Christ is waiting for you there to embrace you in that cross and to be one with you. And with this relationship, nothing and nobody can separate you.
Let's offer our prayers for the Father.
For our Holy Father,